Good morning, and welcome to our continuing series on homeopathy with our beloved Dr. Pachegaonkar. Namaste. Sir, could you tell us a bit about sinusitis? Seems many people are facing this problem. Is sneezing one of these aspects of sinusitis?
See, mainly we have three pairs of commonly affected sinuses. One pair is frontal sinus, the maxillary sinus, and mastoid behind the ear. These are the cavities which are connected with the air passages. So in our respiratory tract, upper tract, nose, throat, ear, we get almost 2 liters of fluid circulated. The mucus is created and it's circulated, and because it is circulated and recycled, it is maintained wet and very efficient mucosa in our respiratory tract. And these sinuses are connected with this tract. Now, anywhere stagnation of fluid in our body invites infection. Because these bacteria, the organisms are everywhere. Wherever there is stagnation, the infection occurs. And when the sinuses get congested and this circulation of fluid, the free flow of fluid is not there in the mucous membrane, the sinuses get congested and then secondarily infected. And that is what we call sinusitis. And it leads to congestion and headache, and it becomes a chronic phenomena. So for this, actually, we first thing is person should hydrate well so that enough mucus is secreted for and getting recycled. Any amount like dehydration will definitely cause it. Then the low immunity, because of so many factors, if it is there, then also the circulation as well as the secondary infection becomes prevalent. For example, like one couldn't sleep properly in time for days together. Definitely what we call the cold settles, it is not resolved. See, sneezing is to certain extent a corrective phenomena, a defense, or we can say physiological. Like suppose I'm exposed to certain pollen grains or some undue dust. Definitely, the sneezing will be induced by the body, and all the contaminations stuck in the passage in the nose will be thrown off.
So sneezing. So it's not a negative.
You shouldn't take it negative if it is with provocation. But sometimes some people develop sneezing as an allergic reaction. It's definitely an overreaction, whereas a normal person doesn't react to it. Some people become allergic. That again is a different phenomenon, because there the susceptibility to such dust is ultra sensitive and person overreacts to it. So sneezing is not the cause of sinusitis, but many times sneezing is indicator of the low immunity and the person developing a bad cold or unresolved cold, and that leads to sinusitis.
It's very interesting, because in California, Southern California especially, the humidity is quite low. But it seems to be more congenial to the body than high humidity.
See, body has a wonderful mechanism of getting acclimatized to that type of weather. But you see, if low humidity means the dehydration will be quick.
Yeah. Oh, yes.
And there you have to ensure that you consume enough of fluid.
Yes.
That's what. Yes. So we suggest that drink ample of fluid so that you get enough mucus to circulate in the passage. Then you should bear a good amount of immunity, optimum immunity, so that you don't develop sort of a congestion in the mucosa to invite secondary infection. So in cases of sinusitis, we suggest that if you have a very bad cold, indolent cold, with sneezing, running nose or soreness and all, we suggest person to eat moderate so that that load doesn't bother the person, plus sleep 1 or 2 hours earlier. So timely sleep and little more sleep, but in proper time. That means like night, midnight should be the midpoint of sleep. So we advise sinusitis person for say a month, if it is a chronic case, we advise that the person should eat dinner by say 6 o'clock or 6:30, and by 8:30, 9 o'clock, one should go to bed. Morning, any time one can get up. It can be 4:30, it can be 5:30, but it should be before sunrise. So if this pattern is followed for few weeks, the flow in our respiratory tract, upper tract, is free, and the sinusitis is taken care of. So we never ask the person to remedy the running nose or something. We ask the person to take enough rest so that the thing is resolved by body itself and then it never recurs. But associated with sinusitis, many times they develop sort of a hypertrophy in nasal mucosa, like swelling, like polyp like thing, and that again can give rise to congestion and give rise to sinusitis.
Wonderful, thank you.